Welcome to the channel Engineering Simplified. Today we are going to be starting a new series on Matlab. In this series, I am going to assume that you have no prior knowledge of either Matlab or any computer language for that matter. We are going to start from the very basics of Matlab and gradually go on to the more advanced stuff. So without further ado, let us begin. The outline that you see on the screen is what we are going to cover in this video. So starting with, what is Matlab? Matlab stands for Matrix Laboratory. It is a computer language which started out in the 1960s and it has been improving ever since. It is a language which is written in two further languages, which are C and C++. Now the question comes, who uses Matlab and what for? Matlab is used by millions of engineers and scientists worldwide. It is used both in the industry and in academia. The applications of Matlab are vast. It is used for robotics, it is used for deep learning, it is used for video processing, imaging, signal processing, financing, mathematics, biology, and you name it. So the applications of Matlab are vast. So, is this course for you? The way this course is designed is that I am starting out with the very basics. So, no prior knowledge is required. So, even if you are in your high school, you are doing your undergraduate degree or even your graduate degree, this is going to be the perfect course for you. We are going to start from the very basics and go to the more advanced stuff. So how are we going to go about this tutorial? I'm going to make a number of videos. Each video would be bite-sized. So typically a video would be less than 10 minutes long. And each video would cover one concept. So one concept per video. There would be a few concepts that would span a number of videos, but generally it would be one video per concept. And after giving you a concept, I'm going to give you a couple of examples of each. There would be times when I would ask you to pause the video and try to write the code yourself, and then I'm going to walk you through it. Now coming to how can you download Matlab. Downloading of Matlab is pretty easy. All you need to do is open your browser and go to MathWorks, and you go to this website MathWorks.com, which is the website of Matlab, and you open it up, and here on the right top you can see this button which says Get Matlab. I am already signed in, otherwise it might ask you to sign in. So you click Get Matlab and it takes you to this page. Here, if you scroll down a bit, you can see that there are three options to get Matlab. The first being to try Matlab, which is the trial version. The second is to get Matlab via your university or school. And the third is to buy an individual license. So, if you are enrolled in a university or a school, the chances are that they already have a license. So, all you need to do is you need to click here for access and you need to fill out the name and email address and submit the form. And if your university already has a license, you are going to receive an email on how to download it. If you don't for some reason and you would still like to try Matlab for free, you can always download a trial by clicking here. And once your trial finishes and you are still interested, you can always go and buy Matlab from this thing. After you download Matlab and you open it up for the first time, it is going to look something like this. The screen is divided into a number of sections. You are going to see on the left there is a current folder, on the right there is a workspace, and in the center there is an editor and a command window. It might look a bit intimidating at first, but don't worry about it. We are going to walk through each of the sections one by one. Let us begin with the top bar. Here on the top bar, you can see there is home, plots, apps, editor, publish, and view, right? We don't need to focus on them right now. All we need to know is that in order to create a new file, all you need to do is you need to go to the new section, click it, and you can select the file type that you need to create. The second thing that I want you to focus on right now is the layout. By clicking on layout, you can see that there are different ways you can arrange these windows. So these sections, editor, command window, workspace, you can arrange them in different ways. For example, like this, two column, you can only view the command window and stuff, right? For now, we are going to leave it at the default. Now, let us move on to this bar here. This is your path or your working directory, right? So this is where all your Matlab files are being stored and the files that you are going to access. Right now, I am working in my C directory within this. This is the folder, this is the subfolder, and this is the folder, right? And within this path, these are the files that are stored in this particular path. I can always move to a different path by clicking here and browsing through this. So it is, I can always change the path. I can always go to this and you can see that the path gets updated. For now, let me go back to here. Now, we have talked about this. We don't need to worry about the details. Now, let us shift our focus to the workspace. So the workspace is where all your variables are going to be stored. So whatever variables you create, they are going to be stored. Let's say you create three variables, X, Y, and Z. They are going to be stored here along with their values and along with their data type. So let's say if you have a variable X with a value of 1 and the data type is, let's say, numeric, it is going to be stored in this workspace. Now let's talk about the command window. Command window is where all your code gets executed. In short, this is where the magic happens. All your code is going to be executed in the command window. But do you write your code in the command window? The answer is no. Generally, you are going to write whatever code you are going to write in the editor. So the code is written here. What happens is you write your code here and it gets copied to the command window and it gets executed here. So very simply, what happens is you write all your code in the editor and when you want to run it, Matlab automatically copies all of the code from here into the command window and it runs it and it shows the output here. That is all for the first video. If you like this video, I would highly encourage you to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on the future videos of this Matlab tutorial, and see you in the next video.